Welcome to Morgellons Discussion and Microscopy Videos with your host, Jeremy Murphree.
Hey, what's up, YouTube, and thanks once again for tuning into our show, Morgellons Disease Discussion and Microscopy Videos. I'm your host, Jeremy Murphree, and today I want to talk about the evidence which demonstrates that Morgellons is not a contagious disease, but rather a part of an infectious process. First, we need to distinguish the difference between contagious and infectious. According to the Wikipedia article on contagious disease, a contagious disease is a subset category of transmissible diseases which are transmitted to other persons either by physical contact with the person suffering the disease or by casual contact with their secretions or objects touched by them or airborne route among other routes. Non-contagious infections, however, usually require a special mode of transmission between persons or hosts. These include need for intermediate vector species, mosquitoes that carry malaria, or by non-casual transfer of bodily fluid, such as transfusions, needle sharing, or sexual contact. So now that we know what the difference between contagious and infectious is, some examples of a contagious disease would be the flu, the cold, tuberculosis, whereas examples of an infectious process would be E. coli on your romaine lettuce, Lyme disease, and malaria. So which kinds of these diseases have been associated with Morgellons in scientific research? According to the 2018 study, Detection of Tick-Borne Infection in Morgellons Disease Patients by Serological and Molecular Techniques, demonstrates that seroreactivity to Borrelia burgdorferi, relapsing fever Borrelia, or both, was detected in 63% of the cohort, while positive PCR testing for Borrelia burgdorferi, relapsing fever Borrelia, or both, was detected in 53% of the cohort. Overall, 90% of patients tested positive for exposure and or infection with Borrelia spirochetes. Of the three subjects who tested negatively, two were taking antibiotics during the time of specimen collection. It is possible that the negative subjects were infected with Borrelia strains that were not captured by the techniques employed in this study. However, it is also possible that spirochetes other than Borrelia, such as treponema and leptospira, may elicit this dermatological condition, and there is published evidence supporting this hypothesis. So as we can see from this research, Morgellons is associated with disease which are typically regarded as infectious and not contagious. Spirochetal infections, even treponema denticoli, which are associated with dental cavities, is known as an infectious disease, whereas you can't sneeze your cavities onto a person. Borrelia bacteria is generally regarded as infectious and not a contagious disease. But if the condition is associated with borrelial infection, why don't the majority of Lyme disease patients present with this condition? A recent study in 2017, The History of Morgellons Disease from Delusion to Definition, states, the key etiological factor contributing to the evolution of Morgellons disease lesions seems to be infection with Borrelia several species, the pathogen most consistently detected in Morgellons disease patients. However, we speculate that the etiology of Morgellons disease is multifactorial. Factors such as genetic predisposition, endocrine influences, immune status, and the presence of other infections, particularly tick-borne co-infections, appear to play a role in the development of this phenomenon. Pathogens other than Borrelia, several species, have been detected in Morgellons disease tissue samples, including Helicobacter pylori, Treponema denticola, and Bartonella henselae. Preliminary genetic studies have demonstrated 9 genes with significant sequence variation in Morgellons disease patients. In Dr. Ginger Savely's book, Morgellons, The Legitimization of a Disease, she describes seeing several hundred patients and having direct physical contact with them, yet even today she herself has not contracted the condition. And the same is true of hundreds of other medical professionals who have had direct physical contact with Morgellons disease patients. They aren't walking out of their practice after being sneezed on developing these skin ulcerations. So to recap, we have empirical scientific evidence which demonstrate Morgellons is associated with an infectious disease process. We have evidence which demonstrates Morgellons may in fact be associated with a genetic predisposition, medical professionals having direct physical contact with their patients, and not contracting the Morgellons condition themselves. If you'd like to learn more about Morgellons disease, please visit our website, www.morgellonssurvey.org. Leave a comment down below so we can discuss this at your convenience. Please visit my PayPal page. I'm not making a lot of money making these videos, and if I wanted to make a lot of money making videos, I would just make video game playthroughs or instructional videos on how to grow your own tobacco. But I want to get the word out that Morgellons is a very real disease. It is not psychosomatic in nature. And thank you to all our subscribers for helping us build this channel up and for spreading the word that Morgellons is a real disease associated with an infectious process.